H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Okay, guys, so let us quickly see this. Okay, so if you see, I'm reading here the scanner. Okay, so you can close the scanner here to avoid the warning. Okay, if you wish, no problem. See now, for example, I've taken the string as fruit name, which is initially blanks string. Okay, then I'm reading the string here using scanner. Okay, so enter the fruit name, for example, because it is string type doesn't have any next int or next string like that. Okay, so it should be only next. Okay, so that is how it will be next only. Now if you see switch, okay, then you have the different cases. So now if you see better, you indent it betterly. So if you see now, so but in general, more than one fruit we can have the same color. So in that case, what we need to do is actually we need to repeat the same code for more than one fruit. In this case, if you see here, for example, apple and a strawberry, they are red. Okay, similarly, mango, banana, they are yellow. Okay, so blueberry, it is blue, blackberry, it is black, something like this. And otherwise, if it is actually invalid value, something like this one. If you see here, we know because we need to repeat the same color for these two fruits, so you can give this one. So you no need to again have another block of code which says that fruit color then break, nothing required. So now what happens, either if it is an apple or a strawberry, so it will actually print it as red. Okay, similarly mango, banana, it will print it as yellow, then blueberry, blue. Okay, blackberry, black, something like this. So you can have as many as possible. Okay, so let us run this guy now. See, for example, I enter apple. Okay, so it must be the same name as in the case, because it is case sensitive too. Remember that fruit color is red. For example, I give another one which is again apple but with lowercase. This is invalid value because it looks for case sensitive with the string. Okay, so that you need to remember in Java. And similarly, for example, if I give strawberry, which is S berry here. Okay, so B must be caps again. See now, color is red. So these two, because share the same code, what happens is whenever you call any of this case, now this will be printed. That's how it is. Similarly, if you run for mango, then it will, or banana, anything, it will give you M should be caps. Hello. Okay, so like this. Now if you see, it is. See, similarly, if you want to give blackberry, then you give blackberry, it must be only one in this case. So if any other thing is, you will get invalid value. Like as you see, when I entered apple with A uppercase, A lowercase, it is actually given as invalid value. Okay, so similarly, like that, you can give that invalid value if any of the case is matching, a mismatching. Okay, so that is how it will be. Okay, so this you need to know, because these two share the same code, so you no need to really create a separate or repeat your code in this case. Okay, so you can have the single piece of block where you want to execute this when both the cases are satisfied. So that's how it should be. Clear?
Srinivas?
Yeah.
The same program, we can do it using if else if ladder, right?
Yes, but I asked you to do this using switch.
Yeah, I did with switch only. The thing is, in the real time, how can we identify that which program, through which this one we can do the program? like in the real time.
It is up to you. When you have more than one case, generally if you have multiple cases, it is easy to do switch. If you have only one or two cases, you do with if else. What is there? When you have multiple cases, it is easy way option to do switch case. Okay, but if you have only two conditions to be checked, in that case, use only if.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, let's get started with the next topic. So today we are going to see in conditional statements only the loops. Okay, so far whatever we have seen is actually execution wise it is top down and you are not going to go back to your steps anytime. Okay, so what we are going to see is today these are the loop statements. What these loops helps is these loops helps us to repeat the certain set of statements continuously until a particular condition is satisfied. Okay, so these are generally called loop statements. Okay, so the first such statement is the while statement in Java. Okay, so the difference between these and whatever we learned that if else and else if is in general, okay, in case of if else if or switch, what you do, your condition execution will be from top to bottom. That means first you have the condition, then you have the set of statements to be executed. Okay, for example, here once you execute the set of statements, what happened? The control actually goes to the after your if or switch case. Okay, so that is how it is generally here. But in case of these loop statements, what happens is if you want to execute a block of statements repeatedly until a particular condition is satisfied, then we use this loop statement. So if you see the condition here, first you actually have the loop condition. Okay, if the condition is true, in case of while it is, okay, see this again, it go back to the condition to check until this particular condition becomes true. So now if you see the diagram here, flow diagram here, you have a condition. When it is true, your body of while loop, that means the steps you want to execute will be executed, and then immediately it will again go to the condition, it will check the condition again. If the condition is true again it will do the same, repeatedly execute the same body of steps. Like that it will continue until this particular condition becomes false. Once this condition becomes false, the control goes to the next statement after your while loop. Okay, so after your while statement or while loop, if you see that here, while expression, this expression is nothing but your relational expression which has relational and logical operators in general, which always gives us true or false only. It is not any assignment operator, so it must be an valid expression only, and it should always give us true or false. Now what happens is whenever your expression becomes true, your set of statements will be executed. Okay, then the control again goes here to check the expression again, whether is there any change in the expression. Now if the expression is true again, it will again execute the same set of statements. Like that it will repeatedly do until this particular expression becomes false. Once this particular expression becomes false, the control directly come to the statement which is there after your while. So that is why these are called loop statements, because these are repeatedly get executed until your expression becomes false. And remember here, in these loop statements, your expression is very, very important. Suppose if you are not giving the proper expression, suppose after a few iterations, okay, what we generally call the repetition in our loops is iteration. Iteration is nothing but iterating your number of statements or iterating your number of statements within that loop repeatedly. Okay, so now after a few iterations, for example, if your expression is not false, then what happened? It may go into infinite loop also. Okay, in that case your program will be doing only this particular statement repeatedly, okay, which is not the good programming. So what we need to have, our expression should be in such a way we should be exit after whatever be the conditions we want to meet. Okay, so that is how your while statements or loop statements works. Not only this while, all the loop statements works like that, whatever you are going to see today. Okay, so generally what happens is, because this expression actually need to be made false based on a particular value. So generally here you do have a variables which we have normally a initializer and then incrementer or decrementer. So that way what happen, we are actually, we easily check for a particular value to be incremented or decremented within the while statement, so that whenever it goes to the expression again, it will check the condition again until it becomes false. We use that incrementer or decrementer in general. Okay, but it is not mandatory we should be using only either incrementer or decrementer, but we need to find a way, whatever be the conditions you want to execute based on this expression, these statements will be executed. And you need to give exit for every while statement or loop statement. That exit should be, your expression should become false, then only the exit happens. Accidentally, if you don't give any of the expression to set to false at any time of your execution, then it will go into infinite loop. Infinite loop is nothing but this particular set of statements will be continuously executed. Okay, it never come out of the loop. Okay, so that's, we should not do that. Okay, so otherwise what happen, your program will be doing continuously there only. Okay, so that is how it happens. Now if you see this guy, let us write a sample while expression for a while statement for a particular small program. Okay, so what I'm going to do, let us say I want to print numbers 1 to 100. Okay, see here, so I call this as using while. Now see this guy, okay, so I want to generate numbers 1 to 100, or I want to print numbers 1 to 100. Without while, how do we generally do? What we do is, I will take I value equal to, suppose 1, okay, let's say int. Okay, now how do I print, see, so I, so how do I print the next one? I value should be 2, means I should print plus plus I. Okay, like that I keep doing the same thing, then it automatically print like this. Let's say I'll print some 6, 7, 8 numbers. Okay, you see the difference now. Fine, 9 numbers I printed. Okay, so this is how we generally print, but the thing is how many you repeat like this, and it is a bad programming. Okay, so now what we do, we use for the same thing, example, see here, 1 to 9 itself I repeated this many times. If I need to have print 1 to 100, what I should do, I should be doing 99 times. Okay, 100 times including I. Okay, so in this case what happened, you are unnecessarily repeating the same stuff just with a different value. Okay, which is not a good programming. So now what we do in these kind of cases, we use actually while statements or any of the loop statements. So first we learn about the while. Now let us see that. Now see this guy, what I'm going to write is a while statement. How do we write while? Is a keyword while, then your condition matters. What is the condition you want to check? What you want to print? You want to print the I value. Okay, what you need to print is until I becomes 100 you want to print. That means you are going to print the I value until I becomes 100. So that value I want to print it. Once your I becomes 101, you want to exit. Now, how can I write a condition to ensure that this condition will becomes false when my I value become 101? Can anybody tell the condition for the initial value for I equal to 1? Okay, I want to exit or I want to make this condition false when my I value becomes 101. How do I do that?
I is equals to 1
I less than or equal to 100.
I greater than 100.
Yeah, I less than or equal to 100.
I less than or equal to 101, because we want to print 100 also, correct?
Yeah, I less than or equal to 100. 100 will print, right?
No. Even we want to print 100 also.
Less yeah, than, yeah, but if you do this,
both are same. Both are same. Either less than or equal to 100 or less than
or I less than 101.
Okay.
Can we do while I is double equal to 100 also?
Double equal to 100 also you do. But in that case, what happens is I equal double
it
equal to
100. It will check only one condition.
Check only first and it will fail, okay, in the first condition itself, right?
Oh, okay.
Okay, I value, what is the initial I value here? 1. When 1 double equal to 100 means 1 double equal to 100 is false. Right? So here the possible condition is either you give I less than or equal to I less than 101 or you give I less than or equal to 100. If I becomes, because already I value is 1, fine. If I becomes 101, this condition become false, correct? Yes or no?
Yes.
That is all. Yes. Okay. Now, for example, let us take any one of them. So, for example, I'll write here simply less than 101. Now, fine. What I want to print I value. So, now CISO I. Fine. First time it will print I value as 1. Now, I value has been printed. Then what we need to do? We need to make our I value 100. 2 next time for the next iteration. So now what happens is here, you know that because this is a while statement, these while loops are actually executed or repeatedly. That means after execution of this I, your control goes here. Okay, now it will check I value again. What is the latest I value? Same, 1 only. I did not change I value anywhere. So this is the reason you may enter into loop if you don't give the proper incrementer. See this guy now. If I execute, what happened? It will repeatedly execute 1111111111 because you did not actually, okay, set your condition or your I value as a anywhere to set your I value based on the condition. See, your I value is 1. You are just printing I value. Every time it is 1 only. Now to print to what should happen, your I value, you must increment by 1 more. See, this is called infinite loop. See, here it is going to print 100 thousands of times or number of times, however you want, until your system is running, it will keep doing that only. We don't want to do that. Okay. See, here you can stop here in the terminate. Done. Okay. Now, how do I know to print the next value? How do I get the next value? If I increment my I value by 1, I will get the next value, which is 2. So like that, it will do. Now see this guy here, plus plus I or I plus plus, anything you can write. Okay. So now what happens here, your I value will be incremented by 1. So whenever I print 1, my I value will be 2. After printing 1, first time it will print 1. Now, what is the latest I value? 2. So when it goes here again, 2 less than 101, true. Okay. So now it will print 2. Now your I value will become 3. Now again, it will check 3 less than 101, true. It will print 3. Now your I value become 4. Like this, it will perform until your I value becomes 100. Fine. What will be your new I value? 101. Now, when your I value becomes 101, what happens now? Whether it will check the condition, whether I less than 101? No, I is equal to 101. So this condition becomes false. When this condition becomes false, you'll be coming out of here. You'll say, suppose after while, so the control, when this condition becomes false, the control directly come to line number 13. Okay, so that is how it is. Now you see the difference. It was going into infinite loop. Why? Because I did not given my incrementer there. Okay, so that is how it is. If you see now, see 1 to 100, it is printed. Okay, then it has printed after while. Why? Because when your I value became 101, this loop, this condition is false. 101 less than equal to 101. No, it is false. 101 equal to 101. Because this is false, the control actually quit this loop and comes to the statement which is there after here. Now what I do, I will show you in debug mode. I don't want to do 100 because it will be take too much time. So I just give some 10 in the debug mode and let us see that. So I will add a breakpoint here, then go to run debug as. See this guy now. Okay, observe this one. What is I value? Current I value 1. Okay, I'm at here at step line number 9 now. Now if I give F5, it will go to the next statement. So what it is printed now? 1 printed. And observe this one, after 11 statement, After 11, your I value will be 2. See there? See here? It is 2. Okay, see, observe here this area. You see the I value. Observe here. Okay, you see the latest I value. So now again, if you see the control, again went to line number 9. But in general, so far, whenever a particular condition is not true, in case of if or anything, the control directly come to line number 13 so far, because these are top down approaches and it never go back, because those are not loops, but while is a loop statement. So then what happened, once it executed your iteration once, it will again go to the while loop to check the condition again. So that is the reason the control again went to line number 9 in this case. Now see this guy. Now what is the new I value? 2. So obviously what happens is, actually your 2 here, the value 2 will be printed. Okay, see that now. F, okay, 2. See the now I value, again 2 is printed. Plus plus I, that means I should be 3. See, okay, 3 changed. Now it will check the condition again, whether 3 less than 10. Yes, true. It will print 3 now. Again, your I will be incremented to 4. See the value 4. Now again, it will print 4. Oops, I'm here. F5. 4. Okay. So again, it will print 5. Like that, it will repeat until 9. See this guy. Okay. 9. 8. 9 is printed. Now, when it is 9, what will be I value? 10. Now it will go and check the condition again, whether 10 less than or equal to 10. False. So see there now. I value is 10 after this. Yes. Now it will again go to the while loop. It will check the condition whether 10 less than or equal to 10. No, it is false. So when this is false, what happened? The control then comes out of this particular loop. So it will come to line number 13. See there. That is how it executes. Okay, so until this particular condition is true, this repeatedly execute the statements whatever you have within the loop. When this particular condition becomes false, this will quit out of the loop. So that means when your expression is true, then only your statements within your while will be executed. If your expression is false, your statements are not executed and the while will be quitting. That means the loop will quit this particular loop, and the control will quit this particular loop, and it will come to the next line after the loop. Okay, so that is how it will be. Clear? That's how it will be. Now if you see, this is what it is. See, suppose 101, you just print, close this guy now. I don't want this. Okay, so now, okay, same. Now tell me, can I print only odd numbers? Yes. If you increment your I value by 2, you will be getting only odd numbers, because I value is 1 initially. If I increment it by 2, what will happen? 1 plus 2, 3, then 3 plus 2, 5, like that. I will get odd numbers. Okay, so that one, for example, here, if you see, I will write another loop for this guy. Okay, let this be there.
Or you can try differently, right? You can use like a remainder at 0.
It is up to you. No problem. See, right now, why to go to remainder and all? Very easy is, you just make it I equal to I plus 2.
Yes,
sir. Or I plus equal to 2, which is nothing but I equal to I plus 2. Now, if you see this guy here, initially, what is the I value? Here, I will make I again 1. Why? Because from this loop, your I value, from this loop, your I value is 101, right? So again, I'm making it to 1. So now it starts with 1 again. Now 1 less than 101, true. Now I'm incremented by 2. That means next I value will be 3. Okay, here 1, 3, 5, and so on. Okay, so here also same. Because it was 1 initially, it will be 3, 5, 7, and so on. Okay, so let's see that now. Done. See this guy? So this one print, first loop printed 1 to 100, my next loop printed 13579. So that way it, your incrementer can be not only just one, you can increment as many as possible, no problem. If you want to print only multiples of 5, so you can say 5, increment it your I value by 5, okay, plus 4, I value is 1, so initially you print 1, next time you want to add print 5, that means I plus 4, I equal to I plus 4, so like that you can do. Okay, now fine, it is incrementer. Can I do decrementer also? No problem, you can do that. Let us see that one now. Now what it is, I want to print from 100 to 1, okay, descending order. In this case, what happened? For example, I take j equal to 100 because this is the initial value I want to print. Now tell me what would be the condition if I want to print
I greater than or equal to 1?
No, j.
J, I, sorry. J greater.
J less than.
J greater than.
J greater than.
I'm equal to.
Okay. So now, sorry, this j should be lowercase. Okay. So now I print j. Fine. How do I decrement every time? Just give j equal to j, j minus 1. R minus 1. R minus j minus j. Correct? R minus minus j. Now if you see, the this guy will print 1 to 100, okay, sorry, 100 to 1 in the descending order. Okay, so this way you can play it. See here, 100 to 1, that's it. Okay, so this is how either you can decrement or increment your values using, but remember this expression is very, very important. If this particular expression is not becoming false after a few iterations, then you may get into infinite loop. Okay, so you need to be careful while using loops. So that is the reason I said incrementer plays a key role here. Either you increment or decrement, that should be there, and your expression must be a valid expression. If your expression is invalid expression, you never get into out of this loop. For example, see this guy here. If you say j not equal to 0, it never get into j, actually until j not equal to 0 for 100 also. Okay, so until j becomes 0, even it will print. So this is also fine. Okay, for example, you want to try this guy out. Let's say, for example, j greater than 100. Now this expression is completely wrong, because what is the j value? 100. You are given expression j greater than 100. It is false, so it never enter into this loop at all. Okay, so that is how you need to be careful while using this. Okay, so you need to write your expression properly and incrementer or decrementer properly. Okay, so that way you'll be using the incrementer or decrementers also. Okay, so that's how it is. Now this is about the while loop. Now we do have one more. So here, if you see that in the while loop, you are checking the condition at the start. Only based on the condition, you are executing the statements which are the body of the while loop. Otherwise, the control directly goes to line number which is there after your while, whatever it is. So that way, it will be executed. Now, there is one more called do while. See this one. The difference between do while and while is, while in case of while, your expression will be evaluated at the start, but in case of do while, your expression will be evaluated at the end. Okay, so that means your do while loop executes at least one iteration. But here it is not like that. If your expression is false, it won't even execute. The directly control goes to line number, which is there in the next state, next after your while. But here it is not like that. It executes at least one iteration because you are checking the condition at the end of your loop, not the start of your loop. Here you are checking your condition at the start of your loop. What is the syntax here? See this guy, do, and you are executing statements only after end of the your loop. You are executing the, you are checking the expression. That means your do while will be executed at least once. Why? Because your condition is not checked initially. So blindly it will execute first iteration. After the first iteration, then your condition will be checked. Based on this condition, again it will take whether to repeat to go to the next iteration, or is this expression becomes false. If the condition becomes false, it will go to the next line. If the condition is true, it will go to the do again and repeat that. Okay, so that is the difference between do while and while. But you can use anything in your program. There is no restriction that you must be using only do while or you must be using while. It is up to you. But remember, do while generally executes your code, piece of iteration code at least once, because you are checking condition at the end. Okay, so that we will see now. See this guy now, the same thing. Okay, now int I equal to 1. Let us do the same thing. We are going to print the same. Okay, so now see the difference. So do while, generally the syntax is do, then immediately followed by your curly brackets. Okay, then while, no, statements means here I want to print CISO I. Now after printing, what you need to do? Increment your I value. So plus plus I. Now check the condition. Now that is the difference. Because you are checking the condition at the end, you must always ensure you. So what happens is these set of statements executes at least once. So by default, the control comes here from do. In this case, what happened is the control first execute this, then only it will check the condition. So you are executing at least once. That is the difference between do while. In case of while, first you check the condition. If your condition is false, you are not going to execute that statements at all. But here it is not like that. Same, I less than 101. Okay, see now, this is using do while. After while, you need to give semicolon here. Okay, so that is the syntax. Now if you see, it is going to do the same. For example, here, let me add